The number of casualties and level of destruction in the Great War far outstripped any other international conflict up to that point. The sacrifice our forebears made 100 years ago was one they made for us, and is one which we must always remember. In 1928, Ypres Police Superintendent Pierre van den Braambusche and his friends resolved to play the last post every day in perpetuity. They did this as a lasting debt of gratitude to the men who fought and fell for the restoration of peace and independence of Belgium during the Great War of 1914 till 1918. Today, as a result of the unstinting and tireless dedication of the Last Post Association, the daily ceremony under the Menin Gate Memorial has taken on a broader and deeper significance, remembering all of those who have fought and fallen in combat. This moving location was chosen because of its powerful symbolic significance. It was from this spot that hundreds of thousands of British and Commonwealth soldiers set off to the front, of which many of them never returned. Those who participate in the Last Post ceremony today are there because of the human stories that have drawn them to Flanders and Belgium, perhaps to trace long lost relatives. Perhaps to accompany veterans of other conflicts who have managed to return after many years. Or perhaps to just pay their own personal tribute to those who went before them. I can testify from my own experience to the emotional power of simply standing under the Menin Gate and listening to the last post. The reverent tranquility of the ceremony provides the space to reflect on the stories of those who fought and laid down their life for their country and friends, or to consider what life was like for those left behind at home. And while many dignitaries have participated over the long history of the Last Post ceremony, it is clear that it brings together people from all backgrounds and walks of life. Together, all of us can listen to the reveille which has come to signal hope for all our futures. We must ensure that the sacrifice and service of 100 years ago are still remembered in 100 years' time. The increasing number of young people who participate in the daily Last Post ceremony is testimony to their commitment to seek to understand what happened in the past and translate it into what this means for them today. Our duty in commemorating the centenary of the First World War is clear: to honor those who served, to remember those who died, and to ensure that the lessons learned live with us forever. David Cameron, Prime Minister of the United Kingdom. Okay, and I'm standing now at the Menin Port in Ypres, and this port was built by the British in 1927, and it was to commemorate the fallen soldiers who never got identified, who are missing in action. So The British built this in 1927, and since 1928, every day, except for the Second World War, when Belgium was occupied by the Germans, every day they commemorate and they play the last patrol on trumpets, every day here at the port. And I will film that for you guys, so let me show you the whole building. So there are almost 55,000 names on this memorial here, and those are names of the soldiers who are missing in action, so who they didn't find, and yeah, they were, are just lost. And it's incredible to see all that names on the wall. It's unbelievable how many names are engraved in the stone there. It's absolutely mind-blowing.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this special episode. I want to thank The Last Post again. I really appreciate what you guys have done, and a special thanks to Yuri. And yeah, we got a big crater behind me, and we'll close the video with that one. I'll see you in the next episode. Salute.